I am supposed to seduce you. At this inspirational event that is all about innovation, I am supposed to seduce you into the future. But I'm a classical scholar. I don't do future. I don't do innovation. If there's any lesson to be drawn from the study of ancient cultures, it is that we cannot learn anything from the past that can help us to predict the future. So instead of giving you a take-home message, I'm going to tell you a story. It's a story about the ancient ethics of not knowing, about living in a world where information is always, in a fundamental sense, lacking. It is a story of the best courtesan in the world, the most beautiful woman of classical Athens, and she is called Theodote, which means literally God's gift. She is an artist. She is a self-proclaimed master of seduction. But it's also the story of the ugliest man on earth, the hideous and disgusting philosopher that we know by the name of Socrates. Now, word travels fast in ancient Athens, and Socrates, when he hears about this unsurpassed beauty of Theodote, decides to pay her a visit and to have a chat. So they do. They talk about hunting, they talk about friendship, and at the very end of the conversation, Theodote asks Socrates to stay with her. But Socrates declines. He's a busy man, lots of girlfriends, lots of young apprentices were all eager to learn the secrets of love magic from him, so she should come to him. And Theodote is definitely intrigued, and she desires to learn more about this love magic, so she says, "Yes, I will, but you should welcome me." "I might," says Socrates, "unless I am otherwise occupied." And here the report of this conversation stops. Here we have a contender of perhaps the most bizarre achievement of Socrates' philosophical career. The ugliest man of Athens has actually seduced Theodote, the master of seduction. At the end of the conversation, it is Socrates who plays hard to get, and Theodote who desires to be with Socrates, willing to take all the effort in the world just to be with him. Now, in Socratic terms, this means that Theodote is in the ideal starting position to become a student of Socrates. She is ready for the quest for truth that we call philosophy. Now, this is a very unorthodox teaching method. So this play with passion, this play with lust, this talk about love magic, it seems somewhat incompatible with philosophy, with the very mission statement of philosophy that is the art of rational thought, the art of looking beyond the here and now. So it seems a risky educational strategy at best. Yet risks and taking risks, that is what Socratic education is all about. Those secrets of love magic, the trait that Theodote will learn from Socrates, is all about risk-taking. It's about becoming a seducer instead of an attractive but passive object of seduction. Because here's the thing. Philosophy takes courage. And courage is not acting on sufficient information. Courage is making a pass in the face of rejection. It's putting forward a suggestion at the risk of ridicule. It's putting trust in someone who might disappoint you. Now, the bigger picture is that ancient morality is more concerned with the courage to give trust than the ability to deserve trust. It's more about trusters than about trustees, more about seducers than about objects of seduction. Virtue is virtue precisely because it presupposes risk-taking, the willingness to take the leap of faith. The grand hero of risk-taking is a person whom we all know very well. It is your own mother. She is the most courageous person in the world. She is the biggest truster. Because not only has she given you the gift of life, but she has also invested years of trouble, worries, and hardship for a person she did not even know when she took on all of this, and without ever being certain that this person, you, will ever be willing and able to reciprocate. She has taken the biggest leap of faith. And because she was willing to take such great risks at so little security, she is your model in becoming a courageous and virtuous citizen. Now, this principle of active partnership, of making the first move, of taking risks, applies to all human relationships. If you want people to invite you for dinner, have them over for dinner first. Make the first move. But not only relationships, but actually everything in human life is premised on trust. Even the most basic acts of everyday life, eating, sleeping, having sex, using language, collaborating with other people, having babies, doing philosophy, they are all premised on trust in a future that is fundamentally unknown. They all require you to accept that not everything can be built on ready-made knowledge. That is Socratic seduction. So maybe innovation is not all about solutions for existing problems. And maybe education is not offering clear-cut answers to ready-made questions. Any educational program that is genuinely future-proof is education that prepares you for a future that is unknown. Education that seduces you to become an active partner. Thank you.
Dankjewel. Dankjewel.